Welcome to The Update, Soul Therapy's weekly news on Korean hip-hop and R&B. I'm your host, Liv. The following update contains spoilers for the latest episode of Show Me the Money 9 that aired this Friday, so please refrain from watching if you don't want to be spoiled. The fifth episode of Show Me the Money 9 aired on Friday, so here's our recap. In this episode, we see the rest of the eliminations from Team Zion T and Geary Boy. Last week, Noah Judah was eliminated, and this week, Kitsyoji and McKid of XS's crew went home. Kitsyoji left cheering his label mate, Kyogai. The triple crew battle for Team Dynamic Duo and BY then started. The team leaders, Kim Mono, Chan Mei, and DSEL started to recruit their crew members. DSEL formed a crew with Untel and Rohan, and Chan Mei got with Bruno Chapman and Kyogai. Kim Mono was left with Rosa Penny and Benzamin. Everyone started to practice, and then the first crew to perform was Kim Mono using BY's One Beat. Kim Mono rapped first, Rosa Penny second, and Benzamin last. Next was Chan Mei's crew rapping over Apro and Geico's beat. Kyogai went first, with Bruno Chapman effortlessly going next and Chan Mei closing up the performance. The last crew was DSEL's crew over Geico's beat. DSEL rapped first, with Untel going next and Rohan last. Their performance was good, but they lacked teamwork and coordination as Untel bumped into Rohan during the chorus. The crews were then ranked Chan Mei's group first, DSEL's crew second, and Kim Mono's last. Bruno Chapman, Chan Mei, and Kyogi were safe from elimination, while the members of DSEL and Kim Mono's group were not. In a shocking twist, Dynamic Duo and BY chose to eliminate Rohan, easily one of their most popular and promising rappers. Untel started to cry after the elimination, but Dynamic Duo and BY reasoned that Rohan was too stagnant and didn't show anything new. Nevertheless, the elimination was an upset to many. The following eliminations were also surprising. Benzamin was eliminated, and so was Kim Mono, the crew leader. Kim Mono is also one of the most popular rappers on Show Me the Money, having caught the attention of many during the second round, and he cried after his elimination. With these eliminations done, the team had lost three really promising rappers. Next up was Groovy Room and Justice's team with Mush Venom, Blase, and Kindy Panda as leaders. The leaders started their recruitments. Blase quickly recruited Munchman and Kid King to become a crew. Kindy Panda recruited D-Ark and Yenjamin. Mirani joined Mush Venom and the Blue Blood contestant, who was obviously Owen Avados, who was edited out due to his marijuana scandal. Funnily enough, both Mush Venom and Blase's crews decided to use the same beat by Indigo, so the two teams would be going toe-to-toe. Mush Venom's crew performed first, with many parts edited out from broadcast due to Owen's scandal. We must assume that the performance was good, but the edit definitely didn't showcase it. Blase's crew went next with the Indigo beat as well. Blase rapped first, and during the chorus, the crew showed their unique color. Munchman went next with Kid King last. Kindy Panda's crew performed last with Soul Romance from Groovy Room. The eliminations then proceeded with Mush Venom's crew ranked first, Blase second, and Kindy Panda's last. Another twist happened with the elimination of Blase, a crew leader, and Yenjamin, who was eliminated along with D-Ark, another really popular contestant. With that elimination round over, once again, a lot of popular rappers have been lost. The final team to go was Team Kopa, with its leaders Swings, Juvie Train, and McDaddy. For some reason, Swings decided to scream into the camera before recruiting Khaki, who he phoned beforehand, and Leon, who sat next to him during the second round. McDaddy recruited An Byung-woon and 365 Lit, and Juvie Train ended up with Kilograms and Jambino. During their performances, MC Kim Jin-pyo accidentally called Swings a producer out of habit. The performances then started. Swings' crew went first with Palo Alto's beat, with Swings rapping first, Leon, who was still dancing in his slippers, next, and Khaki last. They received positive reactions from the producers, and everyone was clearly entertained. The next crew was McDaddy's, and they chose Code Kuntz's People beat. 365 Lit went first, An Byung-woon, who forgot the lyrics and made a lyrical mistake, went second, and McDaddy rapped last. Everyone noted that it was a real shame that An Byung-woon made a mistake. The last crew was Juvie Train's, and like McDaddy's crew, they also chose Code Kuntz's People. Jambino rapped first with Kilograms next. The rappers were noticeably melodic, and Kilograms had really improved from his previous run on Show Me the Money. Juvie Train went last, showing a fresh side of him with his lyrics and unique groove. The final eliminations took place. Swings' crew ranked first with Juby Train second and McDaddy's crew last, as expected. Unexpectedly, Ambyeong Woon, who had been hailed as the potential winner of this season, was eliminated due to his mistakes, which was a real shame. And even Geary Boy said his tone was too good to be eliminated, and he ended up crying after. The episode then ended, and now with only 24 rappers, Show Me the Money 9 is sure to get more competitive.
A lot of people are accusing me and my people for plagiarizing, but no, I'm sorry. I'm here to clear my name.
It's been a busy week for Swings between Show Me the Money, Cox Billy apologizing to him, and the imminent release of his book. After releasing the cover of his upcoming book, Heat, which tells his life story, many fans took to social media to point out that it looks extremely similar to the cover of Minho's album, Take. Swings took to Instagram and posted an IGTV video to address the plagiarism allegation, saying that he doesn't disagree, but that it is 100% a coincidence. Swings claims that they started working on the book way before Minho's album was released and posted screenshots on his story to support his statement, which the cover designer confirmed. Minho's album came out on the 31st, therefore they couldn't have known either to copy it or to avoid doing so. Also, in a surprising turn of events, Swings' longtime rival Cox Billy posted a video apologizing to Swings for his behavior towards him. As you might remember from our Show Me the Money recaps, there was a lot of animosity between the two contestants this year as Cox Billy released a diss track towards Swings after he was eliminated from Show Me the Money 8, on which Swings was a producer. In the video, Cox Billy addressed himself by his real name, Jae Kyun, and talked about how Mommy Son inspired him to be more real as an artist and let go of the Cox Billy character that had gotten out of hand. He said that given the chance, he would like to apologize to Swings and his fans as he goes forward as Jae Kyun, not Cox Billy. It was posted through FTW Independent Records Instagram that Bully the Bastard has turned himself in for illegal drug use and has submitted samples to be tested. But they have since deleted all their posts, and all that remains is a lyric video for Bully the Bastard's song, I'm Sorry. The rapper explained that he has struggled with drugs since high school due to anxiety, but had quit all harder drugs, but still intends to be punished for cannabis use and sent photographs of evidence directly to the police as he offers his sincerest apologies to the public. This has been The Update. Don't forget to like, share, and comment telling us what you thought about this week's news. I'll see you next week.